Project Sam keeps pumping out one free instrument every single month. After a fantastic start with what has to be the best free strings library on the market and an amazingly sounding legato brass library, this month we treat it with accenting winds. So I suggest we let the jingle roll and have a look together. Hi and welcome back. In case you're new to this channel is all about orchestral composition and cinematic music production. And today we're going to have a look at the third released instrument in ProjectSAM's, the free orchestra volume 2. If you haven't done so, you definitely should download volume 2 right now. It works in the free contact player. And if you want to have a look at the review that I've done before for the first two instruments, you can have a look here, where I'm collecting all of these ProjectSAM things in a playlist dedicated to ProjectSAM, the free orchestra volume 2. But now I'll stop talking and we'll have a look at the actual instrument. Let's go. I've already upgraded the free orchestra volume 2. Like so, when I now open up ProjectSAM, the free orchestra volume 2, this is how it's presented to me. It's already telling me that the October instrument is accenting winds. So let's have a listen. That's what it sounds like. It sounds a bit cheeky, like amusing. So let's see what we find. We find the, let's read the description. These woodwind staccatos were taken from Symphobia 1 and 2. Use the big knob, that's this one, to mix in additional muted brass and xylophone. Great for adding accents to your action cues. Good, so let's turn down the brass xylomix all the way down and assign this to a MIDI CC value. Perfect, so now I have the knob here. Mod wheel, okay. And let's see what this sounds like. And it's pretty high up the keyboard, so it goes pretty high up and becomes a bit... It sounds to me also as if there is only one velocity layer. And you have the usual feature of the octaver. And yeah, you have your usual controls, attack, decay, reverb, built-in reverb. Oh, yeah, let's leave it where it was. That's fine. Stereo, field again, makes it a lot wider, or mono. I think I'm gonna leave this one this time the way it is. Filter, oh, that's nice to know. Okay, and now let's have a look at what's the obvious question, and that's what does the brass and xylo mix do? Okay, so first of all, it definitely overdrives my mix console, and I'm not sure why, because this is on 0 dB. So the leveling is a bit weird. Let me turn this down to like at least -8. I'm still clipping quite hard actually, so it is -12. Really loud. -14. Okay, so I'm liking what I'm hearing, which is this. So first of all, xylophone and brass is a combination that's actually quite usual. One thing that I like to do is particularly xylophone and trumpets. That's like staccato trumpets and xylophone. They sound, and xylophone really helps add da 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 this definition to the sound. I'm gonna load up an instance of
ProjectSAM Volume 1 because I have an idea of what might work. Yeah, let's load up this multi and let me play around with this multi. I have no clue what I'm doing here, but I... Well, we're going through this together, and I appreciate you watching me.
If you're enjoying this video, it would mean a lot to me if you could just leave a like.
So, look, like the very beginning was really horrible, so we're gonna it was just me toying around. And let's see what I came up here with. That's what I ended up playing. So let's try to quantize this. Bada 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 bada. And look, I think that I'm gonna have to move a little bit forward to find a place where it starts sounding good, because at the beginning I was struggling to figure out what I wanna play. So now it starts. Let's quantize these. Excellent. And let's cut it out here. And remove this. And now we're gonna grab ourselves. Boy, oh boy. That's the way to quantize. And now let's listen to that. Okay, I shifted here somehow. Right. Okay. Excellent, and now we can cut right here. And here we have 1, 2, 3, 4 measures. So we're going to make this 8 measures, and then we're going to go on to this transition. See, what I'm trying to do is I'm just trying to move up the C minor scale, right? And now we end up on C, B. Let's see. But up to this point, it's kind of nice, right? So it's going to be. Now, this needs to be done. Turn. And these need to go like turn. Okay, so this, let's see what this does. Mm-hmm. Let's see. And copy this over to here. No, only once. Bro, okay. Let's see what this does. We're coming in here. Okay, let's go back to the accenting winds. Maybe I can do something here. Okay, I think I want to have a melody here, so it goes.
By the way, if this is the kind of video that you enjoy watching, I pump out one video like this or similar covering these kind of topics every week. So if you subscribe to the channel, you'll make sure you won't miss out on any future content. Let's keep going.
Yeah, I misplayed there. Ta da dun 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 dun. This goes ta da dun dun. Dun, 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 dun. Let's see, let's see, let's see, let's see. Good, 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 good. Wait, let me grab ProjectSAM 1 again. Wish me luck. This thing here is still way too loud, the accenting winds, but at this point I have the problem that like the sound is a bit unbalanced. Like this is super loud. Starting from here, what I need is I need a change in velocity. So. Let's add volume automation, because why not? That's what it's there for, right? So exactly on measure 38, and what I like to do that is like so. I'm gonna let this go down to minus 17, see what happens. So, here we go. It's 40 seconds of music, spontaneously composed, inspired by what the accenting winds give me as options for sound and opportunity for sound. And I say we have a quick listen as playthrough, and then I'm going to share my final thoughts on this. We'll be right back.
So what do I think? ProjectSAM delivered again. It's a fantastic sound. What I particularly like is how it morphs. I think it's a little bit unbalanced when it comes to loudness. You saw me struggling there and having to do a bit of volume automation, because otherwise, once you let the brass kick in, this patch becomes very, very, very loud. So that's something to be aware of and to kind of manage around when you're mixing it. But other than that, I think the sound is fantastic. I really like the morphing, also like the sound in between. The layering that they chose with staccato woodwinds, trumpets, I believe. It sounds like trumpets and xylophone. It's really, really amazing. Very classy, very energetic. So you can do a lot of energetic stuff with it. That's all for today, folks, and keep creating.